In today's show, we're going to learn how to make your first PowerApps app using some SharePoint data, right? No frills, no fuss. We're just going to dive in there. We're going to connect up to our data, build an app, save and publish it out with people so everyone can see your glory. And then we're going to talk about some tools and tips that you can use to continue your PowerApps learning journey. So if that sounds fun to you, let's switch over to my desktop and take a look. Oh yeah, one more thing. If you go to www.powerapps911.com/start, there you'll see a write-up of kind of things we talk about in this video with some links to other getting started resources and just things I thought would be handy for you guys to have. So go check that out. All right, back to where I was going. All right, so to get started here, I went into a browser on my machine and I went to make.powerapps.com. Going to make.powerapps.com will get you to the right place, right? Because if you're in Europe, your URL is a little bit different. If you're in a government cloud, your URL might be a little bit different, etc., right? There's a lot of different ways that you can end up with a different URL. So make.powerapps.com gets us all to this screen, and it also might be in your language, which is kind of cool. Now, when I got here, I had to sign in and I just used my Office 365 account. If you do not have an Office 365 account, then you can create an account. They'll sign you up automatically for a community plan. But most of you are probably here because you realized you had Power Apps as part of one of your entitlements in Office 365. The best way to get started, I think, is you go down here to create. And so to build your app, there's really three ways you can do it, right? The first one down here is start from a template. The template apps will create an app for you that's already pre-built, pre-configured, and does some things. These apps give you ideas of where to get started. But one of the things I'll caution you as you get into this platform is don't ever try to use these templates. Use the template to get inspired, get ideas, look at how things work, but don't actually try to edit these templates and make them part of your production. It never ends well for customers, right? So if we scroll up here, so then start from, and so basically you have start from data, which is either Dataverse, SharePoint, Excel, or SQL. So these are all tabular data sources that you can start from. And so that's what we're going to use. Or you can start from blank app, and that is literally just a blank white screen that you have to do everything, which is where you're gonna get, right? 99% of the apps in the world that are used are built from a blank app. But to start, for your first app, which we're doing today, we're gonna start with some data, and we're gonna use SharePoint. Because I think SharePoint's the data source you have the most familiarity with, and I'd say 80% of the power apps in the world are built on top of SharePoint. Now you might be thinking, Shane, wouldn't Excel be better to start with? Maybe, but what you'll find out is that while Excel is great for that very first app, just for you to learn maybe, Excel is not a good data source for the long term. So if you want to build an app to work with you and your coworkers, so I don't like to steer you down the Excel road from the beginning. I want you to start with SharePoint. So speaking of SharePoint, if we look over here, I have a SharePoint list that I've previously created. I call it my employees list. Probably 100 of the 200 plus videos I've made at this point are using this SharePoint list. So it's pretty common for my audience to see. But you know, it's just got kind of some simple demographic data. And if we click on list settings over here, just in case you're wondering exactly, there you can grab a screenshot of that. And if you want to know exactly what each column type is, we're not gonna worry about that today though. Okay, so there's our SharePoint list. Now, while I'm here, I know this is the SharePoint list I want to make an app from. I'm going to copy this URL because when we go back over here, we're going to choose SharePoint. And so then this is going to walk us through the process of it automatically creating an app from that particular SharePoint list. So after a few seconds, this screen loaded. Now you see, I have a lot of connections over here. If this is literally your first time, you will not. And so you will probably have to say, create a new connection to SharePoint. So, but there's nothing to it. You just literally say, create a connection to SharePoint, put in your username, or not even put in your account, just say it can use your account and it'll set it up for you. So there's nothing to that process. So then now what do we want to connect to? And so I'm not going to worry about that though, right? I'm not really interested in that because I'd have to find it. That's too hard. Remember, we just copied that URL. Just paste that up here. It's going to be like nothing found. But if you say go, Power Apps has gotten pretty smart and Power Apps figured out that I really meant the site/PA. And so then here are all the lists. And if we remember, the list was called employees. So if we scroll down long enough, we will see that there is the employees list. So click employees. And then we're underneath my face here, we're going to say connect. Now, as part of the connection process, it is going to create us an app, and it takes about 10 seconds, maybe 15 if it's having a slow day. But this is going to create us a fully functional app. Look at that. It's called employees. There are my different employees. And so the very, very first thing I want you all to do right now, slow down, is A, go subscribe to my channel. No, well, I mean, I do want you to do that, but that's not what I meant. But what I really want you to do right now is I want you to click on file over here and then give this a name, right? my first app. Give it some type of name. I don't care what you name it. And then under my face again, click on the save in that bottom right corner. Okay, what this is going to do is this is going to save our Power App, and now autosave is going to run every 2 minutes. You can never lose any of your data, right? Because Power Apps doesn't have like a third-party tool, like a tool you install on your machine. You do everything in the browser to build this. And so if your browser session was to accidentally get reset, you could lose data. So that's why you want to save, because once you've done the first save, autosave will run every 2 minutes. All right, so now we can hit back. So now what we want to do is I want to just check out the app. So up here in the top right-hand corner, there's a little play button, right? Reminds me of my first VCR, if you're old enough to know what a VCR is. And so here, you've got the app. Now you notice it's tall and skinny. So not all Power Apps are tall and skinny. This one happens to use a mobile phone factor, right? You know, you've all heard of this mobile phone, right? Tall and skinny. Well, that's what this is. And that's one of the neat things about Power Apps is you can build them either to be a phone first app, so tall and skinny like this, it works in my browser just fine, or you could build a more of a classic desktop or tablet app where it's, you know, big, wide, you know, big app and uses all your browser real estate. So don't get caught up on the sizing here, but the idea here was they built you a mobile friendly app with the automatic process. So here you can see all the different people from the employees list right down here. There's me. More importantly, there's Chewy. If you watch the videos, you're going to see that there's a lot of Chewy love in these. So Chewy is very popular with my viewers. Anyway, if we go click on Chewy's record, so we'll just click on the arrow. This then takes us to another screen where we can see some additional details about Chewy. So more of his face, but more about, you know, different properties. Like, is he good at his job? What's his favorite color? And if we say edit, maybe Chewy's favorite color is no longer blue. Maybe it's now, hit the drop down, it's now purple. We'll say purple. And then we use this little check mark at the top to submit the item. And just that fast, if we go over to SharePoint and refresh my browser, and we look at Chewy, look at that. His favorite color is now purple. So within seconds, we have a Power App that is working with our data for us, right? So it's working, interacting with the SharePoint list. If we go back over here, so we can see there's a delete button. So if we wanted to delete Chewy, that'd be very sad, but we could delete Chewy. We go back over here. There's also this plus, which would walk us through a wizard and say, hey, you know, create a new one, right? So a new person, we'll call them Bob Buildman, right? I don't know. I just made up something. Fill out blue, department is construction. And, you know, just like that, we entered some data. We hit the check mark. And as you can probably guess, if we go over here and refresh our data and then scroll to the bottom, there is our new person, right? So just like that, Power Apps is done and built us an app. We didn't write a single line of code. We didn't even look at a single line of code. Now what we can do is we can come in here and be like, all right, well, I do not want this whole pop-up wizard. Go away. But we can go in here and we can, you know, start to mess with the app. So with this selected, you're going to notice this is called a browse gallery. That's one of the controls in Power Apps. Remember I talked about this whole idea of it's kind of like PowerPoint. You just kind of drag things in. So there's a gallery. Galleries show you lists of data. Perfect. And so then now if we go over here to the layout, we can change the layout. So maybe you don't have pictures. You want to just change this to just be text. Change the layout to title, subtitle, and body. Boom. Good. But I got pictures, so let's keep those. You can also change what fields show up. So if we click on the fields and say edit, maybe I want that top one to be their first name. So we go right here to first name. And then that second field, instead of being the ID, I don't need the SharePoint ID. Maybe we want to know what department they're from, just like that. And then the face is the face. It's the only image column I have, so I'm not going to change that. And then for the body, we want to show their hourly wage. Boom, look at that. Now we're showing different columns of data. Perfect. But if you look, you might notice hourly wage doesn't look like wage, right? Like Ferguson's missing a zero and I want a number sign, right? No big deal. Click on this. So this item.hourly wage, when you edit a gallery, you just edit this top row and you're in business. But so I can come up here and I'm just going to apply a function called text, which is very similar to Excel. So we're going to say text. And then what do we want to do? We want to use this format, which is exactly Excel's syntax for this. And just like that, you notice that Ferguson got his trailing zero. Everyone got their dollar sign. And boom, you've formatted this, right? You've written your first formula, would be the right word, right? But we used a function, a text function, to transform that number into a formatted number. Also, good news, if you're looking at this from a different country, right? You guys don't use dollar signs. You use the euro symbol or the pound symbol or the yen symbol, whatever it is you use. Power Apps has language specific stuff. So we're not gonna get into that today, but Power Apps is going to, you know, adapt pretty well to you in your different regions. All right, so maybe we're really happy, right? This is everything I ever wanted, Shane. Great. Now what I can do is go over here to File, and we can save this thing. So that will save our changes. Autosave would have got them eventually, but we're just gonna save them now. And then you can publish. So with Power Apps, you have, you know, whatever the published version, that's what your users are going to use. And then but you can then keep editing that and saving your changes, but until you publish it, they won't see your updates. So now we'll say publish. Hey, I wanna publish this thing, great idea. And after a moment, it has been published. And so then now we can go back over here and say file. And it's like, hey, do you wanna share that? I do. So we'll click on share, which opens up a new browser tab. And so here I could share it with, you know, people directly. So we're just gonna share it with Chewy, right? Doesn't your dog have his own account also? So we'll save it directly with Chewy. We could also save it with a Microsoft group or with everyone in the company all at once. We could also choose, does Chewy need to be the owner or not? So Chewy, in this case, we do not want him editing the app. We just want him to use it. So we will not select co-owner. And then the data permissions here, this is just saying, hey, when Chewy opens this app, it's going to interact with SharePoint as Chewy. So make sure SharePoint allows Chewy to do his thing. We'll also send him an email invitation and hit share. And in just moments from now, Chewy will get an email where he'll be able to click on the email and open up the app, and he can interact with our SharePoint data on his mobile phone from our cute little app we've built. So look at that. Just like that, we have built ourselves a productive app. Now, if you get over here, what you'd want to do next is start to explore this app more. So start to figure out, like, hey, when I click on this arrow button, how does that work? Or, you know, how do I make this show not only Steven, but maybe I want to show Steven and his last name, right? So that's a formula like this. And so last name, and boom, we've got that, right? So understanding all of that is important, and that's kind of your next step. Now, we don't have time to do all that in today's video, but if you go over to training.powerapps911.com, right, which is right here, and then you click on Power Apps and Power Automate on Demand, you're gonna see that I have a whole free class here that teaches you how to build your first app like we just did, but it goes into all the details of starting to make those customizations. It also talks to you about Power Automate flows. It talks to you about Power BI. So a lot of learning opportunities in this free course available here. Or if you don't want the structured learning of this, you just want to kind of go piecemeal, then keep in mind that you have other options available for that. Probably the most likely one of those is just to stay here on YouTube and start to type in things. Like if you want to understand how does this gallery work, then just search for Power Apps Gallery and you'll get 1,000 different videos that'll explain to you how galleries work. Or maybe you were more interested in this other screen, like when we went over here. Maybe you want to start to modify this. Well, this is called a form, right? It's a form control. So you could search for Power Apps Forms and find that. And then, you know, the key to getting started from this point forward is just to build an app. Start building, start playing, start tinkering. There's no code, there's no hidden stuff. It's just a bunch of these little controls pulled together with a bunch of functions, and that's what you need to go and learn. So that's it for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Hopefully this gets your mind going. If you have any questions, any comments, leave them below. You know, I've got also at the end of this video, there'll be a link off to the playlist. I've got about 200 videos on all these topics. Just the first version of this one was 4 years old. So I thought we'd kind of start over today with a simpler one. Yeah, and I guess with that, I'm gonna say thanks and have a great day. Hey, me again. Before you go, click on the subscribe button, right? Join the list of 100,000 plus people that have subscribed already. Or if you need any help, right? Check us out at PowerApps 911. We do big projects, little projects. We do training. We do everything and we can help you. Or if you want to see more videos, you probably do, then just click on the playlist above. Cool. Thanks and have a great day.